Zo. I will start my talk now. Thank you very much for coming here and so many people here. Thank you. I want to talk a bit about the changing image of Perl. I'm doing Perl since 1994. I'm a bad programmer. I learned Perl 5 times. I forgot everything about it again 5 times. So nowadays I just don't learn Perl anymore. I just do marketing for Perl. So this year Perl gets 30 years old. And by the time Perl 5 was really released in 1994, it was already very popular. And people were very popular about Perl. Yeah, we can do everything with Perl. Almost nobody said something bad about Perl. We got a nice image of problem solvers in different ways, like the duct tape of the internet or the Swiss Army chainsaw. And I've been there several times that Perl has been used as a Swiss Army chainsaw that other programming languages said, we can't make this prototype with our language, so make it with Perl. And then they stuck with Perl because it was nice. At several times, they kept with Perl until now, like booking.com. 99% of booking.com is written in Perl. Maybe 98.5% by now, but whoever. At some point, the popularity went a bit sour. Perl people started flame wars between themselves and with other programming languages. A lot of people agreed that we needed a break in backward compatibility, which led to Perl 6 at some point. At the moment, Perl 5.24 is still backward compatible to way back. I hope that more Perl people learn the diplomacy that most Perl 6 people have agreed to do. Perl 5 people are getting better at it, nicer. There's hardly any Perl 5 person online anymore that says, "You're all stupid." Some of you know who I mean. At some point, Python and Ruby and JavaScript became more and more popular, and not all those people were as friendly towards Perl, and I'm quite sure that it was vice versa. Like, my language is better than yours. I like to say, your language can do everything that you need as a programmer. My language can do everything as well. There's no need to call each other names. Be friendly towards each other. You learn from them, they learn from us. We help them to develop something and vice versa. We are all in there together. We are open source. Why would we be nasty? But still, people didn't listen to me or anybody else who tried to keep things friendly. So this is what people said to me. So this is my 8th FOSDEM that I have a booth here. And people said that stuff to me. And that was what somebody called me at some point. Well, I think I'm looking better than that, but still. Yes, that was as well. You should not be here. I had a guy coming 3 years in a row at FOSDEM here. As soon as he saw the Perl booth, he started screaming. You should not be here, you should die, you should fuck off, and stuff like that. Really. When he was finished, I laughed at him. I love you too. Making him completely confused, and he went away. But the next year he came again, did the same. He hasn't been there for the last 2 years. Makes me very happy. So, at the time I was like that, sad. I don't want to be sad. And my partner over there and I, we wanted to take action. And we decided, let's try to change something about that. Not many people were working on marketing for Perl. We even had business cards handed out by people. We suck at marketing. What? Come on! We don't suck at marketing, we just have to do it. As soon as we do it like everything else. We have wonderful modules, we have a wonderful programming language, we have wonderful Perlmonger meetings. If we set our mind to it, we do wonderful marketing as well. So I tried to show that. So yeah. Marketing. So we now have a whole lot of stuff for marketing. And at some point I kept maintaining a calendar of Perl events, of places to go to, and trying to go out of the echo chamber. So not just Perl workshops and Yapsi, but also to FOSDEM, OSCON. I've been at FOSCON as well, and I've been at Linux user group meetings and stuff. And they were so surprised to see Perl people there. Like, and then we noticed that they shouldn't be, because our booth was one of the most popular booths. People came by, oh, I'm so happy to see Perl, wonderful. Oh, you're selling camels, how much are they? Wonderful. So, well, we've been here since 2010. So that this is the 8-1 dev room. This is the 7th time we have a dev room. OSCON booth, lots of other stuff. This is a typical Perl booth. And that's my buddy Mark Keating. Mark Keating is the marketing chair of the Perl Foundation and has his own company. And he has done the London Perl workshop for 10 years in a row, and is now taken over by some other people because he was fed up with it. We sell a lot of stuff. We give away a lot of stuff. So how many programming languages do you know who have all this type of stuff? So, like, I know people who have a nice stuffed animal or some beer with their name on it. It's just regular beer with their name printed on top of it. It's not that beer. This is made for us. The Perl 6 wine was made for Perl. Ha. So, after all the negativity, we said, keep calm, code Perl, and do more. So, we still need a lot more. We need people who write books, new versions of books. I asked at some point to O'Reilly, please make some more Perl 6 books or Perl best practices. We want to have a second edition of that. It seems to be difficult for some reason. Really, educational materials for trainers, for schools, etc. Yesterday, I had a professor at my booth, took a whole bunch of tuits because of students don't do their homework. They keep asking me, please make some educational materials. Well, we don't have that many teachers that teach Perl, so it's difficult. We need articles written about Perl. We need journalists at Perl events, and we need more. If you're organizing a Perl event or whatever event as well, invite journalists to your event. They will write about your event. They might write about your programming language. They might write about Perl or MySQL or whatever. All that stuff is good for open source. There's too many managers of big companies that think that open source is nothing. Because it's free, it's nothing. Well, I don't say that's nothing. I think that's quite a lot of people. This was the picture just before Larry Wall announced that Perl 6 would be done that year. That's 2 years ago now. There he was, doing that, announcing Perl 6. Woo. That was that booth that year. Nice. Well, next year, hang on. So, we are doing that stuff. We are bringing Perl to the people. And we, every now and then, we kick some people in the behind to write some stuff. And that's what I do. I make swag. By now, I gave away over 35,000 tweets, 25,000 stickers, 20,000 buttons, 2,000 pens, badge extenders, you know, those little ribbons that you hang on your badge, brochures from different types. I asked people to give me their swag. So companies give me their brochures about how they want to hire Perl people or that they do Perl as well. And if any of you, your company has some Perl swag that you want to be given out at other Perl events, give it to me and I will put it on the table. No questions asked. If it's Perl, I will give it away. I sold a lot of stuff as well. And I'm not making money on this. This is community prices. I sell it for what it costs. And I find out that people sometimes are quite happy with it. Sometimes they still think it's too expensive, and I don't care. Those badges that you see here, every badge pays for 1 hour of work by a Perl core developer, like Jonathan Worthington for Perl 6. And I myself sold 50 of those already. So I made sure that 50 hours have been worked on Perl 5 and or Perl 6 core work. I think that's quite nice. Because of that, a lot of bugs have been solved or new features have been added. This is a typical Perl dev room. I should make a picture of this, but no, I'm too lazy. We're there. Okay, so we stopped the flame wars. We stopped obfuscated code contests. we came in with Modern Pearl. Well, Chromatic did. But we made it a meme, Modern Pearl. Not anymore the old Pearl. We want to have stuff that is documented, easy to read, maintainable, so that people come to my booth and say, ah, no, Pearl, that's a white ones language. Bah. No, it's not. We have a lot of other stuff. And we try to keep a friendly face and friendly writing, and we like to welcome newbies. And something like 10 years ago, we agreed all of that. 10, 12 years ago, we started this change of being more welcoming and stuff. It's paying off. It really is. We've got more jobs. Like what I'm saying there, we've got recruitment agencies only focusing on Pearl jobs. And Pearl companies come to them, I need more. They already, all of the Pearl people have a job. I don't know many unemployed Pearl people. That's a good thing, but also a bad thing, because we need more. It's not a good thing when a company cannot hire Pearl people and then they switch to Python or Ruby or Java or something. That's not good for Pearl. It's good for the other things, but not for us. So we've got more newbies. I've been to a conference in Romania. I looked around the room, it's half of the people are younger than 25. This was an amazing thing. Lots of women, by the way, as well. Lots more than here. Welcome, women. Thank you. So help Pearl and help yourself. Write, blog, present, give presentations like I'm doing now. Go to a hackathon or with your local Pearl user group. Flog. I have seen some flogs. Go to expos, donate, support other ways, chat, patch, whatever. When you write an article or blog or make a website about Pearl, don't call it just Pearl all the time. At least Pearl programming language at least once on every page. At least once. And why? Because Tayobi doesn't look for Pearl, it looks for Pearl programming language. So if everybody does this, we will rise to number 5 in the index again. No, really, that's how it works. 3 years ago, we were number 12. Somebody found out that that's how Tayobi works. Damn, why didn't we know that? Because we didn't search for that. Somebody searched for that, and we all started promoting, doing it like this, that the page will have that text on it. And since then, we rose to number 10, 9. At the moment, we are 8 or 7, I think. I think that's a good thing. Managers look at that list. I know about managers who look at the list. Top 10 is fine. Anything lower than top 10, we don't use anymore. Get rid of all that junk. Nobody's using that, so. So, they see Pearl on 7 or 8, and they think, oh, fine. That's a nice blog. It's a bit of a long URL. I will give this PDF to the website, and you can get it there. And that's just about that Tayobi thing. So, some more nice and shiny pictures of us being happy with Pearl. The last 3 years, I noticed we don't have, or almost have, no nasty comments at the Pearl booth. Yesterday, I had 2. Both of them, Python people. No, nothing else, only Python people. Ruby people come to us and say, hey, Pearl, nice to see you. Java people, oh, Pearl, I'm using Pearl all the time. My work is Java, but all the other stuff, like sysadmin work, I use Pearl for that. Excellent. Nice, thank you. And this year as well, I just had a very nice comment of a Ruby programmer, very nice. Oh, you've got Pearl 6 books, I'm going to buy that. What? But you're working with Ruby. Learn something else, like Haskell or Erlang. Nah, Pearl 6, it looks nice. Okay, fine. So, make me happy, happier than I already have, because the Pearl booth is coming like crazy. Help change the image of Pearl. Help me do the same stuff as I do, or find out new ways. There's more than one way to make me happy, like everything in Pearl. And thank you very much. That's all. Do I have time for questions? Are there any questions?
I still have 5 minutes.
I still have 5 minutes. Well, maybe somebody wants to set up their computer. Any questions? Any discussions stuff? Anybody want to tell me?
Well, you said stopping the obfuscated code comments.
Yeah?
I don't really see that as an advance.
I can be in contact with several managers who complained that you're only busy with stuff that nobody can read, understand or maintain. Stop doing that, because it's really fun, yes, but do it in your own time and don't make a contest of it.
Rephrase it like, stop coding Perl in implicit way. There have been some changes in Perl 5 lately which stop some implicit things which were guiding people wrongly. Be explicit.
Yes, exactly. Any more? No? Thank you very much.